This poem I wrote twice. When my mom read the first one, she said, "You can't write all that stuff. They're gonna throw me in jail." It's where I learned how to hustle. Not that gangster hustle. A woman alone, looking out for six kids hustle. That righteous hustle. My mom taught me not to be sentimental. First thing she pawned was a wedding ring. My mom greets gangster and church people the same, because she knew the church people before they become gangster, and a gangster before they gave their heart to the Lord. My mom doesn't respect no one too much or too little. She smokes 3 packs of cigs a day, if she got one. And if she don't, she picks up stompies and rolls little cigarettes with a phone book. When you haven't smoked all day, every puff feels like a man-sized hit. My mom don't believe in nothing, and she don't believe in everything. And you never know if she's lying. She taught me how to lie, and how to tell a story, and how to worry. The secret is, you go to sleep, you worry better when you're rested. Hammie. Ik heb die gedicht 2 keer geskryf. Van my ma het die eerste een gelees, toe sê sy van my, sy kan nie wel goed skryf nie, en gaan my die tronk opsluit. Het is by haar week geleer het om te hassel, nie raak gangsta hassel nie, maar raak vrou alleen, sorg vir 6 kinders hassel, en righteous hassel. My ma het my geleer om my sentimental te wees. Die eerste ding wat sy gepond het, was haar trouwringe. My ma goed gangsters en kerkmense dieselfde, want sy die kerkmense herken voor hulle gangsters geraak het, en die gangsters voor hulle harte vir die Here gegee het. My ma respect niemand te veel of te min nie. Sy roep 3 pakkies in sy dag as sy het, en as sy nie het nie, en tel sy toppatjes op, en sy 5 voorspilletjes met die phoneboek. As sy heel dag geroek het nie, op elke paf soos een mens sy het. My ma geloof niks, en sy geloof alles, en sal nooit weet of sy ligging. Sy het vir my geleer om te lig, en om 'n story te vertel, en om te worry. Die secret is om te gaan slaap, so worry beter as sy uitgerust is. This one is about my father's contribution to the struggle against the apartheid. Great hero of the people. My role model. Parable. My pa sat one night with us, and he tell us something fucking weird. He shows us when he was young, he and his brothers went to steal figs in the Monte Vista. Where the figs was mostly bush and sand, but it was white folks' houses close by, with fruit trees in the yard. Then it happened that the border chased them. Actually, the border's like this, with some books and stuff like that. But what happened is my pa and his brothers like catch one of the lighters men in the bush and kidnap him. And when they get him alone, they put him down on the ground and one by one take a turn and shit in his mouth. That's the story. The story of my pa took a dump in a white kid's mouth. That's my pa's mother's contribution in the struggle against apartheid. I don't know if it's a parable or a true story. The parable of disgusting cunts. I don't know how I feel about this story. I don't know what hurt more. If someone hit you with some book, or if someone take a shit in your mouth and wipe his ass with your blonde hair. Thank you.